Together, let us pray the 8th novena to Saint John Paul II. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Opening prayer. O Blessed Trinity, we thank you for having graced the Church with Saint John Paul II and for allowing the tenderness of your fatherly care, the glory of the cross of Christ, and the splendor of the Spirit of love to shine through him. The eighth day. People are made for happiness. Rightly then, you thirst for happiness. Christ has the answer to this desire of yours, but he asks you to trust him. True joy is a victory, something which cannot be obtained without a long and difficult struggle. Christ holds the secret of this victory. Dear Saint John Paul II, once again, you in simple words tell us that God is a victorious Savior. Nothing is more important in life than him. Reflection by Saint John Paul II. Thus, the great gift of redemption, our being brought forth to divine life, is a mighty work of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It must be received by us in faith. It must be lived. It must be proclaimed. Pray for the intercession of Saint John Paul II. O Blessed Trinity, we thank you for having graced the Church with Saint John Paul II and for allowing the tenderness of your fatherly care, the glory of the cross of Christ, and the splendor of the Spirit of love to shine through him. Trusting fully in your infinite mercy and in the maternal intercession of Mary, he has given us a living image of Jesus the Good Shepherd. He has shown us that holiness is the necessary measure of ordinary Christian life and is the way of achieving eternal communion with you. Grant us, by his intercession and according to your will, the graces we implore through Christ our Lord. Amen. A prayer composed by Saint John Paul II. Thanksgiving for the Eucharist. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast. O Christ the Savior, we give you thanks for your redeeming sacrifice, the only hope of men. O Christ the Savior, we give you thanks for the Eucharist breaking of bread, which you instituted in order to really meet your brothers in the course of the centuries. Christ the Savior, put into the hearts of the baptized the desire to offer themselves with you and to commit themselves for the salvation of their brothers. You, who are really present in the Blessed Sacrament, spread your blessings abundantly on your people. Amen. Saint John Paul II, pray for us. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us, sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Concluding prayer. Saint John Paul II, you taught the world through word and example that Jesus is the face of the Father's merciful love. You called upon the world to not be afraid and open wide the doors for Christ. Now through your powerful intercession, show us that the love of God is living and active, stronger than all the forces of the world, the flesh and the devil. Through your prayers, help us in every need and deliver us from every evil. May we always know by experience the love of God the Father, mediated through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. God, merciful Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have revealed your love and poured it out upon us in the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. We entrust to you today the destiny of the world and of every man and woman. Bend down to us sinners, heal our weakness, conquer all evil, and grant that the peoples of the earth may experience your mercy. In you, the Triune God, may they ever find the source of hope. Eternal Father, by the passion and resurrection of your Son, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.